I'm not an Invincible fan. I'm really not. I've never read the comic, and to be honest, I thought he was a Marvel creation until just recently. This is of course silly because I'm pretty sure Marvel has only created 6 comic characters and 4 of them are different flavors of Spider-Man. Okay boys, what if we made Spider-Man, but robot? Or what if we made Spider-Man, but future?
I'm not so sure about that, Bill.
Okay, fellas, what if we made Spider-Man, but if he could die of polio? My god, you're a genius, Bill.
Here's the thing, I am a comics fan, but I'm also a himbo when it comes to comics. Outside of the typical Marvel and DC classics, the most adventurous I get with my reading selection is this one comic run about an ice cream man who loves making children smile, and is also potentially a Lovecraftian demon that feeds on the souls of the vulnerable. Invincible never appealed to me. I was vaguely curious when the show, like, just got announced, and I looked up some of the plot summary, and it was honestly the most Chud-like premise I've ever seen. So what if we did a Superman story, but he's evil? How original! But what if this evil Superman story was also mature? Fucking daring today, aren't we? You'd have to be an asylum escapee in order to not comprehend why I would have reservations about reading 3 full compendiums of evil Superman and his shit-ass son. So let's do a reverse Will Smith because it's fast-forward time. And Invincible is released on Amazon. I have no intention of ever watching the show. My read-through of that plot summary honestly did it in for me. But I'm finally wore down by my friend Chris, who has come blasting buckets of hot praise into our group chat about Invincible every week a new episode releases. Him shooting his massive load into the chat actually got me to watch the show. I'm legally obligated to take his recommendations seriously because he showed me the live-action Speed Racer movie, and now I owe him a Moroccan blood debt for allowing me to experience the greatest piece of cinema to ever be released. And you know what? Invincible bangs. It absolutely fucking bangs. Also, this video has spoilers. It's been out since the War of 1812 at this point. I have no remorse for any of you fucks who haven't experienced this wonderful shit yet. Invincible has no qualms with tackling serious subjects, cursing, or showing graphic and bloody violence. There is often 2 types of maturity in blockbuster media. One is a super sanitized piece of meat that really doesn't want to show blood, and if it does, it's little CGI blood splatters that you can barely see. And on the other hand, when something big gets that coveted R rating, it goes balls to the fucking wall with flipboards and torture porn. You'll see this in something like Saw or Deadpool in that those two milk the R rating like me with your mom's boobers. Somehow, Invincible manages to ride that narrow line between weak and exploitative and delivers perfectly gruesome action that thrills and excites. Watching characters get bloodied, get injured in a way that's meaningful and enhances the tension in a way that few pieces of media can do, that shit fucking rules. Everyone and their parents remember that final fight between Green Goblin and Peter Parker at the end of Sam Raimi's Spider-Man. It's absolutely brutal and escalates the sense of urgency and danger in that scene. We know Peter is in a tough position, and we can see that through the torment his body has been put through. Invincible ensures the audience understands just how bad of a superhero Mark is. Like, holy shit, does he get his ass kicked so much? And that's not a bad thing either. Too often we see heroes absolutely stomping opponents. It's honestly a breath of fresh air to see someone that would probably perform as well as me at fighting evil. With Mark getting his ass kicked often and looking absolutely ravaged afterwards, it ensures that those moments where he does have a small success within a larger battle or even land a punch feel impactful. Invincible is one of the few major pieces of media I've seen in the past 5 years that doesn't have what I've disaffectionately started to refer to as the plot character. This character only ever exists to deliver exposition, drive the protagonist towards some sort of new development, or push the plot along. There's nothing wrong with using characters to push the greater needs of the story when it's done cleverly and spread out amongst all the characters within that narrative. but oftentimes writers will rely on one or two characters to do all this heavy lifting. Every individual in Invincible exists as a character first and used as a tool for the greater narrative second. Each character has their own opinions and complex motivations. No one just exists for the sake of moving the story. Cecil could easily just be used to escalate tensions and progress the conflict along, but he has many scenes where he isn't doing any of that, and we get a look into what drives this man. Honestly, after the first few episodes, I was sure Cecil was going to be that character, but a lot of what he doesn't actually progress the story forward, and that's not a bad thing. Not every action has to increase the dramatic weight. Some actions can and should fail, only serving to develop that specific character doing the actions. Cecil releasing that monster that I've definitely seen in at least 5 hentais didn't really do anything besides show how desperate Cecil was and what he was willing to do to save the Earth. All of the characters are like this, and they are all fantastic. My one minor complaint regarding characters is the usage of the teen team throughout the season 1. Yes, I understand they have major significance throughout the series, but in season 1 they didn't really have much to do in terms of the overall story. Characters shouldn't just exist to serve the story, as I said earlier, but they also should contribute in some way. And I feel like the members of the teen team outside of Adam Eve didn't necessarily contribute in an impactful way. That isn't to say I didn't find them to be interesting and wildly unique, because they are easily some of the best side characters I've seen in quite some time. I just wish they had a little bit more to do. I want to kiss Nolan on the face, like holy shit, he's such a great fucking character. Like, yes, I understand he may have done some murder.
Oh no.
But he's also just a really interesting individual and has them clappers, if you know what I'm saying. I may be coming across like those girls on TikTok who simp for Ted Bundy and say they would have gotten him to do less killing because they're built different. But honestly, this is a different situation. I can at least recognize that me banging Nolan's brains out won't affect his motivations in the slightest. It's Mark who does the affecting. And oh boy, is it ever so compelling to watch. Mark and Nolan's dynamic relationship, watching that shift from episode to episode, kept me watching. I can rave about the gore or the other characters, but this thread was the main reason for my continued viewing. I honestly have no idea how the show is going to hook me without Nolan being present in season 2. Like, it's such a good fucking dynamic. My single favorite series is Dragon Ball. What I absolutely love about that series is how the protagonist, Mr. Son Goku, has the power to change his enemies' personalities and even motivations just through him being around them. In that same way, Mark impacts Nolan, not through his pleading during that final fight, but all of the relationship building events we get to see prior to that final episode. We get to see Mark and Nolan grow together, and we don't get to see the fruits of that relationship until the very end, and what a sweet fucking payoff it is. They have such a strong connection that it stops Nolan from murdering Mark. And like, yeah, I get it. That's pretty bare fucking minimum for parenting. But considering where Nolan's starting viewpoint is, it's a significant change. If I had to place a bet, I would imagine the next through line would be between Mark and his mom, or Mark and Adam Eve. I want to see those two grow together and develop a much more complex relationship. I also want to see them fuck. I want to see Mark and Eve finally get together. I don't want to see Mark and his mom have sex.
Excuse me, the fuck did you just say?
I don't want to see them have intercourse. I meant that I wanted to see Mark and Eve get into a romantic relationship. Please, I didn't mean—
FBI, open up!
Thank you for watching, gamers. I apologize for being gone so long, but it do be like that sometimes, you know? But updates on me and my life: I finished a semester at college, I started working at Chipotle, and I now have a girlfriend, and I no longer have a girlfriend. My girlfriend was your aunt, and she was very sweet to me, and I used to take her out for bowling every Thursday night. Cheryl, please call me back. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and a comment. Also check out another one of my videos. Have a great day, esteemed gentlemen and gentlewomen.